When I first started producing music, I had to figure out how to sidechain. So I went to YouTube, I did a search, and I was overwhelmed by the amount of videos I found on the topic and tutorials showing me how difficult it was to sidechain. Today I know better, it's not difficult at all, so I put together this video to show you how simple it actually can be done. If you want to skip ahead, you will find the chapters for this video. You can just skip to the one about sidechaining. But first, a few words about when it is used. And the most common usage is for the kick. So you want to make the kick punch through your mix, and then you will use sidechaining to clean out the frequencies on other sounds. Another usage is for the vocals. So sometimes you will sidechain the instruments to make room for your vocals. Also, if you have a very complex soundscape, it can be hard for some sounds to stand out, such as a guitar or a hi-hat. You can then also use the sidechain to compress the sounds in the soundscape to make room for these guitars or hi-hats. Another usage is for accentuating the rhythm to bring rhythm to your track. So you can add sidechaining to many elements of your track just to get this pumping rhythm in your track. And this is very popular, especially in EDM and also hip hop. Sometimes you can use it for parts of your mix just to make some differentiation, but be careful not to overuse it. Just find a balance that works for your music. So then we will go into FL Studio. For this video, I have a simple track with a bass and a kick that I want to sidechain. Before doing anything, this is how it sounds. So you can hear that the kick is not really standing out. That is because the bass is occupying a lot of the same frequencies as the kick. So when we sidechain, we are actually freeing up that space. We are reducing the volume of the bass when the kick hits. If we go into the mixer, you can see that we have two channels with the bass. We have the sub bass and we have the rhythmical mid-range bass. We also have the kick in our channel, and we also have a pad that we will come back to later. So one way you could do it is that you can add a fruity limiter on each bass and you can trigger it with the kick. But to make it even easier, I will make a separate channel where I will route both the basses and apply the sidechain effect. So let's make a channel. Let's call it sidechain. Let's give it a color. And we will dock it to the left so we have some system in our mixer. The first thing we will do is go to each of the bases and link it to the sidechain channel. You can see that by default it's linked to the master. Instead, we want to link it to the sidechain. So we go down here, right click, and we select sidechain to this track only. And we do the same for the other bass, sidechain. And now both of the basses are going into this channel. And then we also need to set the volume to 100 for each of the basses. So now both of the basses go into the sidechain. The next step is to add a fruity limiter to this channel, the sidechain. So now we have this added. The next step is to give it instructions on when to adjust the volume of the basses. For that, we will go back to the kick and we will route this one also to the sidechain. You right click and sidechain to this track. Now the volume needs to be at 0, and the volume will also go to the master. So you can hear that the kick is not impacted when you are changing the volume. Now we go back to the fruity limiter and we want to change to comp. Right click on sidechain and we select kick, because the kick is the channel we want to decide when the effect is applied. Gain we keep at the same level, also the saturation. The threshold we can set based upon the volume in from the basses. Let's see. And also the ratio, I'll place out here. And the rest you can play around with based upon how it sounds in your mix. So now you can see that you have the purple areas. This is where the volume is decreased on the bass to free up space for the kick. So now we have sidechained both basses through the sidechain bus, with the kick deciding when it should be reduced in volume. This is how it sounds. So when you put the threshold at the right level, you also get the right effect on the kick. So you can hear that the kick is more dominant the lower you have the threshold. And as a reference, I will also add kickstart. And then we can hear how this compares. So it's quite similar, so I'm quite happy with the settings on the sidechain. We also have a pad running on the track, and the pad does not really compete with the kick in the same frequencies. So if we go to the pad, we activate it, and then we go to the mixer, and then we can run a EQ on it. You can see that most of the sounds and the frequencies are in this area, while the kick is mostly in the lower range. So it doesn't compete as much. But for the pad, I will add a sidechain directly on the pad instead of going through a bus. We do it in the same way. You add the fruity limiter. And then you also have to route the kick to this one. So you highlight your kick, you right click on the arrow and sidechain to this track. Make sure the volume is 0. We go back to the pad. Then you go to the fruity limiter and you can select COMP, comp, right click on sidechain, add a kick. And then we make the same settings also for this one. And the reason to sidechain the pad is not, as mentioned, to clear up the lower frequencies, but it's also more to give a drive to the track. So when you have this rhythmical drive, then everything sounds a bit more energetic. So now we can play all of it, and we try to turn on and off the sidechain to see how this affects it. And that's how easy you can sidechain in FL Studio. I hope the video was helpful. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.